Hudson, and I'm delighted that you're spending the time with us each day for our daily devotions. And today we're going to continue on with the book of Psalms in the Old Testament. We're going to continue on. We're going to Psalms chapter 2 and verse number 1. Again, it's Psalms chapter 2 and verse number 1, and hopefully I will see that on the board shortly so that you can read that with me while I'm doing my devotion. It's so important that happen. Psalms chapter 2, verse 1, the Bible says, "Why do the heathen rage and the people imagine a vain thing?" Today we're going to talk about the first part of that verse. Why do the heathen rage? Talking about rage or anger, a do-it-yourself catalog firm confirmed the following letter from one of its customers. It said, "I built a birdhouse according to your stupid plans, and not only is it much too big, it keeps blowing out of the tree." Signed, "Unhappy." The firm replied, "Dear Unhappy, we're sorry about the mix-up. We accidentally sent you a sailboat blueprint. But if you think you are unhappy, you should read the letter from the guy who came in last in the yacht club regatta." When you think about it, what was it that made them so angry? What did they see that made them angry? What did they hear that made them angry? What happened to them that made themselves angry? And when you finish asking these two questions, you must come to the conclusion that they were not angry for absolutely no reason, but they were angry possibly for a reason, but more likely they were probably angry for many reasons. And more often than not, we deal with the symptoms of our rage and never the root cause of the rage that we're displaying for all to see. A lady one time came to Billy Sunday and tried to rationalize her anger and her angry outbursts. And she said to Billy Sunday, "There's nothing wrong with losing my temper," she said. "I blow up and then it's all over." And his reply to her was, "Well, dear sister, so does a shotgun, and look at the damage it leaves behind." You see, some scholars seem to think that the psalm was written just after David had become a new king, and perhaps the enemies thought this was the perfect time to come against the nation because they would be more vulnerable against an attack. And they all gathered against him. Who, you specifically ask? Well, the Philistines. And they quite possibly were attempting to get the revenge for what he had done to their champion in the Valley of Elah and to their armies, and also what he did to the men at the request of the former King Saul. So he could gain Saul's approval. And they said one of the reasons why they were coming is the Bible says in 1 Samuel 21:11, "The servants of Achish said to him, 'Is not this David the king of the land? Did they not sing to one another him in dances, saying, Saul has slain his thousands and David his 10,000s?'" You see, Benjamin Franklin said, "Anger is never without a reason, but seldom with a good one." William Penn said, "It is he who is in the wrong who gets first angry." You see, what David did at this time is recorded in 1 Chronicles chapter 14 and verse 10. The Bible says, "And David inquired of God." David went to seek the Lord. And before you make a decision, before you make a move in life, and before you do it in a time of anger or time of not knowing really what to do, make sure you spend time talking to God, inquiring of the Lord, because at that point, God can either tell you, yes, do this, or no, you do not need to. And when David inquired, chapter 14, verse 10 of 1 Chronicles, the Bible says that God told him, "Go up, for I will deliver them into thy hand." Well, David also reached another point in his life in that same chapter where he asked the Lord again. He inquired of God again. We think we inquire one time, that's all we need to do. Let me tell you something. God's waited all day to talk to you. Maybe you should spend some time talking to him today. He has some things he'd like to share and talk with you about. And the first time that David inquired, God said, "Go up, for I will deliver them into your hand." The second time in verse 14 of that chapter, David inquired again of the Lord, of God, and God said, "Thou shalt not go up after them," because God had some other plans, and God was going to, you see, everything we do in our life is supposed to bring glory to God. It's supposed to show that we see how good God is. And when God gives him this in 1 Chronicles 14 and 15, says, "And it shall be when thou hearest the sound of the marching in the tops of the mulberry trees, that then shalt thou go out to battle, for God has gone out before thee to smite the host of the Philistines. And chapter verse 16 of that chapter, the Bible says, and David did as God commanded him. I pray that that's something that you can say in your life and your time. And if you haven't done it up till now, then today would be a good day to start and begin to do all the things that God has commanded you, asked you, spoken to you about doing. The Bible says, and they smote the host of the Philistines from Gibeon even to Gezer. In 1 Chronicles 14, 16. Ecclesiastes chapter 7 and verse 9 says, be not hasty in thy spirit to be angry, for anger resteth in the bosom of fools. Ephesians 4 and 26 and 27 says, be angry and sin not. Let not the sun go down upon your wrath, neither give place to the devil. I would like to read that from a couple of different translations. Another translation says, be angry, yet do not sin. Do not let the sun go down on your anger, nor give the devil a foothold. Do you realize when you keep anger in your life, it allows the devil to have a foothold in your heart? Ephesians chapter 4, verse 26 again says, when you are angry, don't let that anger make you sin, and don't stay angry all day. Don't give the devil a way to defeat you. I want you to know that your anger, when your anger is out of control and it's not kept under the blood of Christ, you don't keep your attitude right and you're angry, you give the devil a foothold in your life and you actually supply a way for the enemy to bring you to defeat. Frederick Buechner, Wishful Thinking Transformed by Thorns, says of the seven deadly sins, anger is possibly the most fun. To lick your wounds, to smack your lips over grievances long past, to roll over your tongue the prospect of bitter confrontation still to come, to savor to the last toothsome morsel both the pain you are given and the pain you are giving back. In many ways, it is a feast fit for a king. The chief drawback, though, is what you are wolfing down is really yourself, and the skeleton at the feast is you. I challenge you today, be careful with what you do with your anger, because the results could be deadly. I challenge you, take your anger to a prayer closet, talk to the Lord, and give your anger to Him, and let Him fill your life rather with peace. Because we used to sing years ago, if I'll hold my peace and let the Lord fight my battles, then victory shall be mine. Let's pray. Lord Jesus, I pray that you would help us today, God. Help us to gain the victory over our anger, Lord Jesus, and angry outbursts and things in our life. Because when our anger comes, God, we want you to control it. We want you to help us through these times. Because, God, we don't want to give the devil a foothold in our life. And we certainly don't want to give him any place that he can overcome us. God, we come to you and we ask you to help us through this. Not just this day, but every day that we live and move and have our being in you. I praise you and thank you for it in Jesus' name. God bless you. Thank you for being with me today. Hope you enjoyed this devotion. Come back tomorrow. We'll finish the verse 1 of Psalms chapter 2. God bless you. Have a great day in Christ.